Hi, I'm Richard Halley. I study glaciers and ice sheets, and they're fun. They're really cool. They're really cool. We're going to go and look at the ice of Greenland. You can also go to the ice of Antarctica. Greenland and Antarctica are places where it snows more than melts, and the snow builds up, and it builds up, and it builds up until it's a pile that's 2 miles thick, and it's a whole continent wide, and it spreads under its own weight. The snow falls on top, the ice spreads down to the coast where it breaks off to make icebergs, or where it melts and runs away. As that snow piles up, it makes an incomparable climate record. If there's dust in the air, the dust ends up in the snow. If there are micrometeorites falling in from space, they end up in the snow. There's pollen in there. As the snow is squeezed to ice under its own weight, it traps bubbles that are actually the old air. If you want to know how much greenhouse gas was in the air before we humans were around, go drill some ice core, break the bubble, suck out the air, and analyze it, and you will find out. We can find out how old the ice is because summer snow and winter snow look different. It doesn't get warm enough on top of Greenland or Antarctica to melt, but the sun shines in summer, and so summer snow and winter snow look different, and it's like tree rings. Summer, winter, summer, winter, summer, winter. You can count the years. We can figure out how cold it was in the past in Greenland or in Antarctica by looking at the ice core as well. There's many ways to do the temperature. One really neat one, you drill your hole, you let it sit for a couple of years, and then you put a thermometer on a string and you drop it down the hole. And a mile down in Greenland is colder than the top, and it's colder than the bottom because a mile down has not finished warming from the ice age yet. If you take a frozen turkey and you put it in the oven, it takes a few hours till it thaws in the middle. Well, the center of Greenland is still warming from the ice age. Another way that we get the temperature is a little higher time resolution. It's really neat, too. Water evaporates from the ocean, and probably about 1 in 500 water molecules, one of the atoms has an extra neutron or two in it. It's heavy water. It's fat water. It's water. It's chemically water. It's normal water. But there's a little bit of heavy water. As an air mass moves over Greenland or Antarctica from the ocean, it cools. And as it cools, it makes clouds, and then it snows, and the heavy water falls out first. The colder it gets, the more of the water falls out, the more of the heavy water falls out, and you start running out of heavy water, so the snow is only light water. And by measuring the ratio of heavy to light water in the snow, we can look at the history of temperature on top. When we use different thermometers and we compare them, they give the same answer. And so that gives us confidence that this is working very well. And so we can go through an ice core and get these wonderful records of how the climate has changed year by year going back in time. To get that ice core, if you want to drill a hole in the door to make a doorknob, you often use something that's sort of like a tin can with little teeth cut in the end, and you put it against a door and you spin it on your drill and it drills through. Well, we do that. You take a pipe, and on the pipe there's little teeth, and you put a motor on it and you hang it from a tower and you push it against the ice and you spin it and it cuts down into the ice, and then you pull it up and you take that piece and you analyze it. You cut slices off and you look at different things, the isotopes and the dust and the meteorites and so on and that, and then you do it again and you do it again and you do it again and you do it again until you've drilled through 2 miles and you've pulled up this wonderful record. And of course, you got to know what you're doing, and it takes a lot of really smart people and people who work hard to make that drill and make it work so it doesn't get stuck and it gets you the right answer. But in the end, we get these beautiful records, and they tell us history. So you are going to get to do a little bit of ice coring, virtual ice coring. You'll get to look at data. You'll get to do all sorts of fun things. And so what we're going to do is jump on our snowmobile, and we're going to run out to the drill site, and we'll get you started on a little scientific inquiry on ice cores. So let's see what we can do here. Got to get the goggles on. Got to get it. It's cold out there. And let's go.